saying? We do give you credit, Stephen Espinoza, because one thing you have did in the past year is y'all have took over boxing in the sport. What was once dominated by HBO. Can you tell us the method to the madness of how Showtime have just came in and just wiped every other boxing off the way?
Well, it's you know, it's been a long process. It all came to fruition and got to that point within the last, you know, year, 18 months, 2 years. But, you know, for example, with Errol, we did his pro debut on Showtime. You know, he was, and that's a rare thing for us to do. And our strategy was 3 or 4 years ago to build a group of talent. You know, the thing about boxing, you can rarely predict who the superstar is going to be. I mean, sometimes once in a while, you know, coming out of the Olympics, you knew Oscar De La Hoya was going to be a superstar. But no one could have really predicted early on that Floyd Mayweather would become as big as he did. So our goal was, our strategy was to develop a good pool of young talent, marketable talent, you know, aggressive guys. So fast forward 3 or 4 years, and we've got that core group. You know, Keith Thurman, Danny Garcia, Errol Spence, Sean Porter, Deontay, you know, the featherweights with Abner and Leo and Carl Frampton. So at that point, there's a lot of talented guys. You know, I don't know who's going to become the next pay-per-view superstar, but I do know it's going to be one of these guys. You know, it could be Deontay, could be Errol, could be, you know, Keith, could be all of them. But the core is to develop that group of talent that when they mature, you've got a whole, you know, a number of great fights you can do.
So I know that you are close to the Keith Thurman situation because it's a mystery on Keith Thurman right now. You don't know what's going on. First it was he has shoulder surgery now.
Right.
He had a hand injury. It's a lot of people around the world starting to question Keith Thurman. And if his heart still is in boxing.
Right.
You talk to him on the regular, I'm sure. Mm-hmm. Can you give us an update on that?
I think sometimes Keith gets misinterpreted. He's a guy with a lot of interests. You know, he likes to read. He's into music. He's into art. He's into travel. He likes to travel a lot. And that's not what we're used to seeing out of fighters. So sometimes people look at this and say, he's traveling to the Far East. You know, he's reading. He does meditation. You know, maybe his heart's not in boxing. But the reality is, you know, I know he's got the hunger. I know he loves the sport. He's had some terrible luck between the car accident, the elbow injury, and now a little bit of a nagging hand injury. You know, he's away from the sport. But I do believe that had it not been for those injuries, we would be talking about Keith Thurman and Errol Spence, you know, later this year. Now, maybe that gets pushed back to next year, but I still think we're going to see that fight, and it will be a barn burner.